One more time, I want to read this to you. Because of the extravagance of those revelations, as I looked at a big head, I was given the gift of a handicap to keep me in constant touch with my limitations. Satan's angel did his best to get me down. So what he in fact did was push me to my knees. No danger then of walking around high and mighty. At first I didn't think of it as a gift, and I begged God to remove it. 3 times I did that. And then he told me, my grace is enough. It's all you need. My strength comes into its own in your weakness. Once I heard that, I was glad to let it happen. I quit focusing on the handicap and began appreciating the gift. It was the case of Christ's strength moving in on my weakness. Wow. On my weakness, on my pain, on my corruptness, on whatever, it was there. My limitations, there was the gift of that thorn. The gift of that thorn. Wow. God is so awesome. I thank Him that He loves me enough to put a catfish in my tank. I thank Him that He loves me enough to come out and cut all the bushes down so they can grow back up the way they should. I appreciate that everything He allows helps. It doesn't hurt. Isn't that beautiful? Beautiful.
In my life. They're not there to kill me, they're there to strengthen me. And I think changed so many things in there that we weren't able to have a Christmas party for them. But you know what? That didn't matter to them. They were just happy we were there. So please be praying for these ladies. There's other men. There's men in prison. They're going to be going home. They need your prayers. Thank y'all.
God is awesome. I guarantee you see it in a different light. I told the church about this. Last Monday night, a friend of mine, was taking his emergency room, bowel blockers. And I was asked to pray for him. I said, okay, I'll pray for him. I was going to go see him that afternoon, but I forgot. So I'm sitting in my office, in the living room, doing a nine-page paper. Mom put his nine-page paper. Linda looks over and says, honey, did you go see your friend? I said, oh, no. So I text him. And when I text him, I said, you still in the hospital? He said, yes. I said, what room are you in? He said, 329. I said, I'll be right there. Only a mile from there. I told Linda, I said, I'll be right back. I'm going to take a minute and go back to work. I get my car, I drive to Beaufort County Hospital, I get up on the third floor and it hits me, 329 is the maternity ward. And so I texted him again, I said, are you in Beaufort County or Pitt County? He said, I'm in Pitt County. I said, well, I can't go tonight, but I'll see you, buddy. I'll be praying for you. I gave him my diagnosis. He said, thank you, doctor. Something to do with Jesus being today. On the way down, I said, Lord, this is a wasted trip. And the Holy Spirit put right in my heart. I said, no, it isn't. He's not the one you came to see. I walk downstairs. I don't see anybody. As I'm walking across the parking lot, there's a person as far as you're reading the door out of there. And in just a brief light, I saw his face. He weren't there. I saw his face and I saw his countenance like I've never seen it before. He walked over toward me and so I walked over toward him. And I said, what's up? He said, you ain't got time for me. I said, yeah, dude, what's up? And he started talking to me. And this awesome man that does some awesome things said, God don't hear me anymore. He said, I asked God to help me. And he hasn't listened. He said, I need some help with this problem. And I don't know what to do. And I said, can I tell you something? So I said, God did hear your prayer. He said, how do you know that? I said, because I wasn't supposed to be here tonight. And I said, after I went upstairs to see somebody in the maternity ward and one woman, I realized I was in the wrong place. But the Holy Spirit told me I was here for somebody else, and that's you. And he started crying, and I said, you're looking at this all wrong. He told us, look at it all wrong. You've got to change the way you look at it. If you change the way you look at it, it'll change your behavior. It'll change your countenance, everything. And of course, he got called in the hospital, so in the hospital, so later, he texts back and says, how can you say that God was listening to me? And I just think it one more time and said, okay, what about you told me? I said, you ain't gonna do what I said. I said, I just gave you a different perspective, but if you want to be able to breathe tonight, try. So now he knows God did hear his prayer. Therefore, purpose. Don't we get a fishing rod and say, God, help me get them out of the pond. Just let them do their thing. Thank God for your thorns. I love roses. Can't smell them, tear me up. The prior time I get around them, not because they tear me up my voice, but I can't breathe around them. But I love the way they look. I just don't like grabbing those thorns. Complain that roses have thorn bushes, or thorns, or you can rejoice that thorns have roses. I choose to rejoice that thorns have roses. My thorn has got a rose. I know it does. I ain't seen it, but it's there. Your thorn's got some roses. If you can just love your faith. God is awesome. All the